Hi everyone. In this session, I would like to have about design of biogas plant with the help of a numerical example. Before going for the design of biogas plants, first we can see what are the points that we have to keep in mind before we select the site for a biogas plant construction. First point is that the distance between the point of source and the point of use, that is point of source means the point at which we are constructing our biogas plant, and point of use is the kitchen where we are using where we have placed our biogas burner. So that distance should be less so that we can reduce the cost, and that distance having an optimum value is about 10 meter for almost a 2 meter cube capacity of biogas plant. Next point is there should be minimum gradient for conveying biogas plant from the biogas gas from the plant to the point of use, and minimum gradient requirement is almost 1% that so that the gas can flow easily from the plant to the kitchen. Next point is there should be enough open space available so that the sunlight can fall on the biogas plant to maintain the temperature between almost 15 to 30 degrees Celsius for the optimum working condition of the biogas plant. Next is the water table. We all know that mostly the biogas plant is constructed, especially the digester is constructed beneath the ground. So if there is a high water table level, there may be chances that in the rainy season the water table can interfere or will come in contact to the digester, and the water can comes inside the digester, and that will affect the working environment of the biogas digester and it may not work properly. So it is not suitable for construct a biogas plant if the water table is more than 3 meter. Next is seasonal runoff. The same problem here: in the rainy season, if the runoff is fall into the digester through any leakages or anything, then that also affect the working condition of the biogas plant. So care must be taken that there should be proper facility to prevent the interference of rainwater into the digester. Next is distance from the wells. We know that in the digester we are feeding our waste materials, cow dung, etc. So that there may be chances that it may seep from the digester to go to the well water, and it may contaminate the well water. So in avoiding the contamination of this digester slurry from the digester to the well water, there should be a minimum distance of 15 meter that should be maintained to avoid the seepage. Next is availability of water. We all know that plenty of water is required for mixing the feed material with the biogas feed material for the optimum biogas production. So the required total solid content in the digester for optimum biogas production is almost 8 to 10%. So to make the total solid content of the feed material to 8 to 10%, we want to mix it with the proper amount of water. So if it is a cow dung, we will mix it with the equal amount of water. So we have to add plenty of water to make the total solid content to a desirable level. So the plenty of water must be available in that particular site. Then space requirement should be there so that there should be some for daily operation and maintenance. For example, mixing of the slurry and then adding the slurry, then taking of the digestive slurry from the other side. So there should be enough space requirement should be there for the day-to-day activities. The recommended value is almost 10 to 12 cubic meter area needed per cubic meter of the gas production. So the source of cow dung or the feed material should be there so that we can minimize the transportation cost. So these are the 9 points that we have to kept in mind before we select a site for biogas construction. Now we can go to the design of biogas plant with the help of a numerical example. So I have taken here one problem that design a biogas plant. They mention the type, that floating drum type, for a farmer who is having 6 cows and 6 calves. And in addition to domestic cooking requirement of his 5-member family, he intended to process the milk for value-added products. And the question is, how many hours he will be able to use this 2-burner biogas stove for milk boiling after meeting his domestic cooking requirement? So this is the question, and we can split the question into 2 parts. First, we have to design a biogas plant whose especially the floating drum type with the cow dung from 6 cows and 6 calves. That is our first part. Second part, after meeting this, the farmer is having 5-member family. So after meeting the 5-member family cooking requirement, he wants to boil some amount of milk with the help of 2 biogas burners. So how many hours he can able to burn or work this burners? So that is the second part of the question. Now we can go to the first part of the question, and the important point in the first part of the question is that he is having 6 cows and 6 calves. Okay, now moving to the first part, that is the design of the digester. That is the main part of the biogas plant is digester, within which the entire anaerobic digestion process is taking place. So first point that we have to kept in mind, he is having six calves. So the average value of cow dung from one matured cow is almost 10 kg. So average value of cow dung from a matured cow from a single day is almost 10 kg. So from a single day, he will get almost 60 kg of cow dung from his matured 6 cows. Similarly, he is having 6 calves. So the average value of cow dung availability from a calf in a day is almost 5 kg. So he is having 6 calves. So dung availability from the calves is 5 into 6, that is 30. The total dung availability of that for particular farmer is 60 kg of cow dung from his cows and 30 kg of cow dung from his calves. So totally he will get almost 90 kg. And here, so we always wanted to mix it with the water so that to make the total solid content to 8 to 10%. So we know that the cow dung is almost contained 18 to 20% of total solid content. That is 18 to 20% solid content is there in the cow dung. But our required value is 8 to 10%. That is better half. So in order to make that 18 to 20% to 8 to 10%, we will add equal amount of water. How much amount of cow dung is there? We will add equal amount of water so that we can make that TSS to better half. So we have to add this much amount of water also, and this is given in kilograms. So we can consider as the specific weight of the dung as 1 kg per liter. So we can write this 90 kg as 90 liters itself. So 90 liters of cow dung will be available in one day, considering the specific weight as 1 kg per liter. And then we can calculate this daily slurry volume, that is cow dung plus water, that is we called a slurry. So daily slurry volume is equal to 90 into 2, that is 180 liters. So 180 liters of feed material is available for that particular farmer to feed into that digester. And in this point, we have to consider the retention days also, because in a single day, he wants to add, or he will add almost 180 liters. The second day also, he will add 180 liters to the digester. Third day also, he will add 180 liters to the digester. And if the retention day is 40 days, at the 40th day, when we add his 180 liters of that particular 40th day, the 180 liters will add in the first day will move out. After the complete digestion, it will move out of the digester. So 180 plus 180 plus 180 plus, etc. up to 40th day, he want to add almost 180 liters of cow dung per day, like that. So the digester capacity should be enough to contain almost this 180 liters of feed material up to 40th day. So the detention day is 40th day. So the total volume of the digester is 180 plus 180 plus etc. plus up to 180, that is 40 into 180, whatever it is. So volume of digester is equal to 180 into 40, that is 7200 liters. We can write that into cubic meters, that is 7.2 cubic meter. So next, that will provide extra 10% for the overlapping of the gas holder. Why we provide this extra 10% is that in the question itself, they mentioned that it is a floating gas biogas digester. In a floating gas biogas digester, suppose this one is the digester, and the gas holder will floats over the digester. That is, this much amount of digester volume is not intended for the storage of or the slurry. It's for free floating of the gas salt. So this 10% extra should be we have to take. Okay, so we will take almost 10% of this digester volume extra for the overlapping of this gas salt. So while considering the 10%, we will get 7.2 into 1.1 whatever it is, or into 110 divided by 100. So we will get almost 7.52. We can consider it as a round it 7.5 only. And next point is that is the volume of digest was 7.5, that we almost got. And we in the previous slide we saw that the digester is almost in a cylindrical shape. So the volume of cylinder is equal to pi by 4 d square into height. So this hd is the height of the digester, d is the diameter of the digester. So 7.5 is equal to pi by 4 d square into hd. And we are considering that the height to diameter ratios should be between 0.67 to 1. So in this case, we are considering the ratio values as 1:1, that is diameter is equal to height for ease of calculation in particular in this problem. So that is d is equal to hd. So instead of using this hd, we can use this capital D. So the equation will become pi 7.5 is equal to pi by 4 d cube. So in this equation, the only thing that we don't know is d cube. So using this equation, we can calculate the value of d, that is almost 2.12 meters. We can round it that to 2.1 meter or 210 centimeter. So diameter of the digester is 210 centimeter, and same the height of the diameter is also 210 centimeter. So the dimensions of the digester is all over. And next we can move to the design of gas holder. So first point while considering the design of gas holder is that how much gas is produced per day if we are feeding 180 liters of feed material into that in one day. In that 180 liter of feed, only 90 liters are cow dung. So the dung, the biogas productivity of cow dung is almost 35 to 40 liters per kg. So that is from 1 kg of cow dung, we will get almost 35 to 40 liters of biogas. So we are here, we taken as 40 liters. We say we get 40 liters of biogas from 1 kg of cow dung. Here daily we are feeding almost 90 kg of cow dung. So the daily gas production is almost 40 into 90, that is 3600 liters or 3.6 cubic meter. Okay, now this 3.6 cubic meter has to be stored in that particular gas holder. So and another design criteria is that we don't want to store the entire 3.6 meter cube. So how we calculate like that, the gas which is produced in the night time is will be taken in the morning time for cooking the breakfast and also for the lunch, and the gas which is there in the produced in the daytime will be utilized for cooking the dinner. So only the 50% is needed to be stored always in the gas holder. Other 50% we will daily we will use up. So only 50% of this 3.6% is 3.6 meter cube is needed to be stored. And the diameter of the gas holder, we can consider how the diameter of gas holder is taken. So say this one is our digester and this one is our gas holder. So we always kept in mind that the diameter of the gas holder should be less than the diameter of the digester. So how much less? That is the next point. So usually for the free floating of the digester, we will always provide 10 centimeter clearance in one side. We will always provide almost 10 centimeter clearance in one side. So on both sides, we will provide 10 centimeter. So 10 plus 10, almost 20 centimeter clearance we will provide for free floating of the gas holder over the digester. So the diameter of the gas holder can be calculated from the value of diameter of the digester minus 20 centimeter, that is for free floating clearance of 10 centimeters provided on each side. So diameter of digester we find in the previous session, that is 210 centimeter minus 20 centimeter, that is almost 190 centimeter or 1.9 meter. And next, that is we already mentioned that assume the gas to be stored is only 50% Okay, so that is 3.6 cubic meter, which is total gas production in a day, by 2. That is almost 1.8 meter cube is needed to be stored. So the volume of gas holder is 1.8, and the gas holder is also in the cylindrical shape. So 1.8 is equal to pi by 4 d square into hg. G is the height of the gas holder, and d we know from this point, and 1.8 pi by 4, 1.9 square into hg. So only thing that we don't know in this particular equation is hg, and we can calculate the value of hg from this equation, that is almost 0.365 meter. And also we can take almost 15 centimeter of the submergence height. This height is almost 15 centimeter. So we will take the total height of the gas holder as 15 centimeter plus the calculated height. So we will add this 15 centimeter with the calculated value, will get 0.65 meter. So that is about the design of gas holder. Now let's move to the design of slurry mixing tank, or dimensions of the slurry mixing tank. We know that we will get almost 90 kg of cow dung, and we have to add almost 90 liters of water to that one. So we have to mix it properly. That is not possible with our buckets or anything. So for that, for mixing that slurry in a proper way, we can construct a small mixing tank. And usually we can take the mixing tank cross section as rectangular cross section or square cross section, and for most comfortable. So the daily slurry that should be mixed in that particular slurry mixing tank is 180 liters, that is 90 liters of cow dung plus 90 liters of water, and assuming the depth of 40 centimeter, because always a man has having comfortable level, considering the comfortable level of 40 liters. If the height is more, he have to be raise his hand to mix it properly, and if the height is too small, he have to bend forward a lot for mix it properly. So in an average value, we can take it as a 40 centimeters. So we know that 1.8 meter cube is needed and 40 centimeter is needed. So volume we know and depth we know. Then from that we can calculate the area. Area is equal to volume by depth. That is 0.18 meter cube divided by 0.4 meter. That is 0.45 meter square. That is the area. Considering the slurry mixing tank is having a cross section of square cross section, that is L into B is equal to, or L square is equal to 0.4 meter square. From that we can calculate the side of the slurry mixing tank is almost 0.67 meter, or that is equal to 70 centimeter. So this is about the design of biogas plant. Now we can see, we can draw a figure of like this is a digester of diameter 210 centimeter and depth of 210 centimeter. And this is our gas holder of diameter 190 centimeter and height of 65 centimeter. So this is the design of biogas plant. So the first part of the question, that is designing a floating drum type biogas plant for 6 cows and 6 calves, is over. Now the point is the calculation of how many hours the burners, 2 burners, will work after meeting the cooking requirement of this farmer. So the gas requirement per hour for one burner is almost 300 liters. So working one burner for 1 hour, it requires 300 liters. Totally, the farmer is intended to burn 2 burners, right? So 2 burner for how many hours, that we don't know. So for 1 hour, it almost requires 600 liters, right? And how much amount of gas he required for his cooking requirement is that? So standard value for cooking requirement for one person for one day is almost 300 liter. So for cooking requirement of a one person is almost 300 liters of biogas plus in a single day. So the farmer is having a 5-member family. So 300 liter per day into per person into 5 persons. That is, it will almost 1500 liters per day. That is 1.5 cubic meter per day. So daily gas production is almost 3.6, that we already find in the gas holder design. So 3.6 meter cube gas is produced per day, and only 1.5 meter cube is required for cooking requirement. So the balance gas is available for the burners is 3.6 minus 1.5 is equal to 2.1 meter cube. So this 3.6 we calculated in the design of gas solder. In case of any doubt, you can go back to the video and see that one. And that is 2.1 meter cube. So now the 2.1 meter cube of gas is available for operating the burners. So for one burner, it requires 300 liters, and for two burners, it requires 600 liters. That is almost 0.6 meter cube is required. So we have almost 2.1 meter cube. So number of hours which is we can use is almost 2.1 divided by 0.6 is equal to 3. That is equal to 3.5 hours. That is, after meeting his cooking requirement of 5-member family, the farmer is able to use the two burners for almost 3.5 hours to heat his or to boil his milk. So that's about the design of biogas plant. In case of any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you.